depreciation. I think yesterday we did two problems on written down value method. Okay, let us continue. Let us do one more problem. Write down. ABC Limited. ABC Limited. ABC Limited purchased. ABC Limited purchased a machine costing 10 lakh rupees. A machine costing 10 lakh rupees. A machine costing 10 lakh rupees on 1st April 2014. Installation and site preparation cost. Installation and site preparation cost came to 2 lakh rupees. Installation and site preparation cost came to 2 lakh rupees. So to prepare the site and to install the machine, we have spent 2 lakhs out of pocket. We said ABC Limited purchased a machine at a cost of 10 lakh and they have spent 2 lakh rupees on installation and site preparation. Continue. The machinery is expected to have a depreciable value of a residual value of 3 lakhs at the end of its life. Management decided to depreciate the machinery by 25% per annum under reducing balance method. Not required. When rate is given, you need not be given the life. If you are given life, you are given original cost, you are given scrap value, you can check whether the rate given in the problem is correct or not. Is it clear? But in this problem, wantedly I am giving you the cost, I am giving you the scrap value, but I am not giving you the life. I am straight away giving you the rate of depreciation. Okay. Continue. The machinery was disposed on 31st March 2017 for 6 lakhs rupees. Prepare machinery account for the year ended. December 2014, 31st December 2015, 31st December 2015, 31st December 16, and 31st December 17. So accounting year of the company is calendar year. Okay, it starts on 1st January, ends on 31st December. But when was the machine purchased? 1st April 2014. That is during the calendar year 14. During the year, not at the beginning of the accounting period. During the accounting period. When was the machine disposed? During the last accounting period, 2017. So, in in the first year the machine was not used for full 12 months. In the last year also machine was not used for full 12 months. It was used partly in the first year and also partly in the last year. Continue. Now to start preparing the machinery account. Machinery account. Debit, credit. Please be quick. By now we have done so many problems on machinery account. You should be thorough with the format. When was the machine purchased? Please tell me.
First April.
1st April 2014, we purchased the machine. At what cost? At a cost of 10 lakh, but we also spent 2 lakh on, I think I told you, machinery account should be debited with original cost. Original cost includes purchase price, but after trade discount. Add non-refundable duties and taxes. Add packing, freight, insurance, expenses during transportation. Add installation and site preparation costs. So whatever expenditure is incurred till the coconut breaking ceremony, will all have to be treated as capital expenditure included in the cost price of the machine. See, in our religion, what we do is we'll definitely put one buttu to the machine and we'll break a coconut and we'll tell, please work properly, don't create trouble for me. So till that time comes, whatever expenditure you are incurring is all capital expenditure. Once it starts commercial production, in such case any expenditure from there on will be treated as a revenue expenditure, unless the expenditure can increase the capacity of the machine or bring about reduction in costs and benefits will come for more than 1 year. Only in such case such expenses can be added to the cost, or else you have to write it off. Okay, you have debited to the P&L account. I think you have learned already, no?
Yes,
revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure. So continue. So installation and site preparation cost should also be debited to machinery account. To bank. How much? 12 lakh. What is the entry? Machinery account at R2, bank account. 10 lakh plus 2 lakh, 12 lakh. Over? No. When will the accounting year end? 31st December 14. So from 1st April 2014 up to 31st December 14, we have to provide depreciation. How many months? 9 months. Calculate 9 months depreciation on your calculator. What is entry you have tried for depreciation? Depreciation account at R2, machinery account. By depreciation, 12 lakh into 25% into 9 by 12, how much you get?
2,25,000.
By depreciation, 2,25,000. Carry down. 31st December 14. Carry down. How much the balance? 9,75,000. He's sleeping. Now here, sir, what about scrap value? Somebody has subtracted scrap value, that is why you said 675. Because scrap value will be left at the end of the useful life. You keep depreciating at 25%, at the end of the useful life, you should find that there is a scrap value of 3 lakh. We are not going to subtract scrap value and then debit the machinery account with the cost price. Are you going to understand? Next. 1,115. Two balance brought down. 9,75,000. When will this year come to an end? 31st December 2015. By depreciation, 9,75,000 into 25% into 12 by 12. You need not do 12 by 12 because it is full year. How much? Now once you get this, no, what you can do is just take calculator, type 9,75,000 into 25%. You'll get depreciation. I want balance now. Minus equal to. Just type minus equal to get the balance. Carry it down. How much is the balance? 7,31,250 rupees is the closing capital balance. Closing asset balance. 1,116 brought down. 7,31,250. 31st December 16 by depreciation. Quickly tell me what is depreciation now? On this 25%. 1,82,812. 0.5. Right? 0.5. What is the problem? You have a calculator. Carry it down. Balance. 5,48,437.5. $1,117 brought down. How much? 5,48,437.5. When was the machine sold? Only on 31st March 17. That means only 3 months. By depreciation. 5,48,437.5. Into 25% into 3/12. Wait, don't be in a hurry now. Please tell me how much amount did we get by selling the assets?
6 lakhs.
When you buy the machine, what is entry you part? Machine account at R2 bank. When you sell, reverse. Bank account at R2, machine account. So right here, buy bank. 6 lakhs. Now is the account getting closed? Once you have sold the asset, asset account cannot continue in the books. It has to be closed off. Are you able to understand? When the asset is disposed of, account should not continue. It has to be closed. So how will you close the account? Which side is more? Credit side is more than the debit side. There is some profit which will be transferred to profit and loss account, to P&L account. Once asset is disposed, this account becomes a nominal account. It has to be killed by transferring the balance to the P&L account. How much amount? 85,839.5. Whatever it is. Balancing figure. 85,839.5. So here you have written. See, you have written an entry here. Machinery account at R2 P&L account. Means P&L account should be credited. So profit will be transferred to the credit side of the profit and loss account. Okay. So we can show this calculation by way of a statement also. Right on. Calculation of WDV on date of sale. I want to find out WDV. What do you mean by WDV? Retained on value. What do you mean by retained on value? The value remaining after providing for depreciation till the date of sale. So how do you calculate? WDV on 1,117, 548, 437.5. This was the opening WDV of the year. Less depreciation up to 31st March 17, date of sale, 34,277. WDV on date of sale, on date of sale. What is WDV on the date of sale? Please subtract and tell me. Then what is it? WDV on the date of sale? 5,14,160.5. This is the WDV on date of sale. Okay. Now calculation of profit or loss. Sale price minus WDV on date of sale. How much is the sale price? 6 lakhs minus, this is also called as book value on the date of sale. This is also called as book value on the date of sale. 5,14,160.5. How much do you get? 85,839.5. Profit. Why profit? Sale price is more than WDV on the date of sale. Hence there is a profit. If it was reverse, this was sale price, this was WDV,
loss.
If sale price is less than book value, loss. If sale price is more than book value, there is a profit. Okay. Can we prepare the same account in the form of a statement? Learn that also. Write down. Statement showing WDV of the machine on date of sale. Instead of preparing the account, we should also be able to prepare a statement. Can I have this? Particulars, calculation, rupees. Original cost 12 lakh. On which date it was purchased? 1st April 14. Less depreciation from 1/4/14 to 31st December 14. Calculation column 12 lakh into 25 by 100 into 9 by 12. It was 2,25,000. Same account, we are just preparing it in the form of a statement now. Depreciation schedule also we call it as. How much is it? 9,75,000. This is called as WDV on 1,150. Less depreciation from 1/1/15 to 31st December 15, 9,75,000 into 25%, 243,750. And get WDV on 1/1/16. How much is it? 7,31,250. Less depreciation from 1/1/16 to 31st December 16, 182,812.5. WDV on 1/1/17. 548,437.5. Less depreciation from 1/1/17 to 31st March 17, 548,437.5 into 25% into 3/12. It is 34,277. WDD on date of sale. How much is WDD on the date of sale? Please tell me. ₹5,14,160.5. This was the WDD on the date of sale. Suppose the problem says the machinery was depreciated at the rate of 25% SLM method, then
same
question. No, if it is SLM method, depreciation per annum will remain the same. It's not going to reduce every year, no. In such a case, we need not prepare such a long table also in SLM method. Please find out. From date of purchase up to date of sale, how many years in this problem? From 1st April to 1st April 14 to 31st March 17, 15, 16, 17, exactly 3 years. Okay, so we can find out WDD in this manner. Press on button on your calculator. What is the original cost of the machine? 12 lakh. Type 12 lakh into 25%. What is that? 3 lakh? Depreciation per annum. For how many years? 3 years into 3. What is that? That is depreciation for 3 years. From 1st April 14 to 31st March 17. It is how much? 9 lakh. Type M minus on your calculator. I have put in memory minus. Put 12 lakh in memory plus. Type 12 lakh. Memory plus. MRC, what is that? 3 lakh. That is your WDD on the date of sale. Compare that with the sale price to calculate profit or loss. Sir, but first year 9 months, no? First year 9 months, last year 3 months. Boss, it doesn't make a difference in SLM method. Per month depreciation will remain the same. In 14, we'll charge depreciation for 9 months. In 17, we'll charge depreciation for 3 months. 15 and 16, 12 months and 12 months. 9 months, 12, 12 and 3. Which is equal to 36 months. Per month depreciation will remain the same. Simply 36 months is nothing but 3 years. Calculated directly for 3 years. Everybody understand? So SLM method is very easy to implement, whereas WDD now you have to prepare the statement because depreciation every year changes. Next, write down sum of digits method. Write down. This method is similar to WDV method. Depreciation per annum. keeps reducing every year. Depreciation per annum keeps reducing every year. Depreciation for a particular year. Depreciation for a particular year can be calculated by the following formula. Depreciation for a particular year can be calculated by the following formula. Write down. Depreciation for the year is equal to depreciable value divided by sum of digits. Depreciable value divided by sum of digits in life, right? Sum of digits in life into in the numerator open bracket, right? Remaining life plus one. Close the bracket. What is the formula? Depreciable value divided by sum of digits into remaining life plus one within brackets. Okay. So write down. What is sum of digits? Write down. What is sum of digits? If life is sum of digits is equal to 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Sum of digits is equal to 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. How much? 50. N into n plus 1 by 2. Correct? Sum of first n natural number. N into n plus 1 by 2. What do you mean by real numbers and natural numbers? Natural is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Real is, you know, you also have 0. Fractions also. Natural is no fractions. No, I am trying to learn. I am poor at maths. Continue, write down. If life is 10 years, sum of digits is equal to 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6 plus dot 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 plus 1. 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. How much is it? 55. Okay. That is the meaning of what? Sum of digits. If life is 15 years, 15 plus 14 plus 13 plus 12 plus 11 plus 10 plus 9 plus dot 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 plus 1. Write down the problem. Sir, what is the logic behind the method? We'll learn. Write down. Original cost of the machine original cost of the machine 1,60,000. Himnesh, did properly. 1,60,000 original cost of the asset. Depreciable value, sorry, not depreciable, residual value 10,000. Original cost of the machine 1,60,000. Depreciable value, residual value 10,000. Residual value 10,000. Right. Life 5 years. Life 5 years. Write down. Calculate depreciation for the year 2014, 15, 16, 17, and 18. Calculate depreciation for the year 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, and 2018. We have purchased the machine which year? 2014. Calculate depreciation. What is the formula I taught you? Depreciation for a particular year is equal to depreciable value of the asset divided by sum of digits into within brackets remaining life plus 1. Look at the board, everyone. Depreciation for a particular year is equal to depreciable value divided by sum of digits into remaining life plus 1. This is the formula now. So for 2000, before we start applying, let us calculate sum of digits in this problem. Sum of digits is how much? 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, 15. Why 5 have started? Because life is only 5 years. Now, depreciation for 2014. This is the first year in life. Depreciable value, tell me how much is it? 1,60,000 was the cost. Estimated scrap value 10,000. Divided by 15 is sum of digits into what is the remaining life from 2014? 4 years plus 1. In 4 years left now, remaining life plus 1. So it is 1,50,000 divided by 15 into 5. How much? 50,000. It is 50,000. For 2015, what is the depreciation?
1,50,000.
Depreciation for 2015, it is 1,50,000 divided by 15 into 3 plus 1. It will be 40,000. For 16, it will be 1,50,000 divided by 15 into 2 plus 1, 30,000. 20,000 for 2017 and 10,000 for last year. 2018 will be 0 plus 1. What is the logic being followed in the formula? Formula looks neat. Calculation also looks neat. What is the logic we are following? See, the logic is like this. Depreciable value 1,50,000. What is this? This is the loss which is going to occur over a period of 5 years.
So we are just sharing the loss over a 5 year period.
The loss is 150,000. We are expecting to, we can say, spread this loss over a period of 5 years. That is what is depreciation. What is depreciation? Allocation of depreciable value over the useful life of years. What is allocation? Share. Sharing. Dividing. Now it has to be shared over 5 years. 2014, 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018. How should we share? Equally. If I say equally, 1:1 ratio of a share. Just divided by 5, 30,000 per annum. Equally. But what did we say? This method is similar to WDV method. Depreciation per annum keeps reducing. Initially you have to charge more depreciation and later on you have to start reducing the depreciation. So I give a weightage of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This amount has to be shared in this ratio 5:4:3:2:1. How much is it?
Same thing.
50,000, 40,000, 30,000, 20,000 and 10,000. This is the logic behind the formula. You all completed? Let us do one more problem. Write off. A machine was purchased at a cost of 24 lakh rupees. 24 lakh rupees. On 1st January 2014. On 1st January 2014. Having a estimated scrap value of having a estimated scrap value of 2 lakh rupees, full stop. Life 10 years. Method of depreciation, sum of bins method. Method of depreciation, sum of bins method. Calculate. The written down value on 1st January 2018 depreciation for 2018 and profit or loss and profit or loss if the machine was sold for 10 lakh rupees. So you are not, see, without preparing account, don't do it. Straight away you have to prepare 2018 account. Write down machinery account for 2018. Machinery account for 2018. Machinery account for 2018. Wait, are you talking? Brought down 1118. Question mark. Hey, tell me, what is the opening WDV on 1118?
22 lakhs.
How 22 lakhs? 22 lakhs. It was purchased for 24 lakhs on 1st January 2014. 14, 15, 16, 17. 4 years are over. What is the WDV left now? Written down value, find out that. So, two balance brought down. Question mark. By depreciation 2018. Question mark. By bank. We are selling away the asset for what value?
10 lakh.
You have to calculate profit or loss. I don't know whether we have profit or loss. So you have to calculate the WDV on 1st January 2018 first. Working note. Calculation of WDV on 1st January 18. Particulars. Calculation. Rupees. Particulars, calculation, rupees, calculation of WDV on 1st January 2018. Original cost on 1114. How much was it? 24 lakh. This would have been debited to the machinery account on 1114, no?
Yes.
On the first date of the year, this was purchased. This would have been debited to the machinery account. Out of this, we would have provided depreciation for 14, 15, 16, 17, 4 years. Then you will get the WDV on 1118. So, less depreciation for 14. What is the formula? Sum of digits we have to follow. Depreciable value divided by sum of digits into remaining life plus 1. So, it would be 24 lakh minus 2 lakh divided by, what was the life? 10 years. On a calculator to calculate the sum of digits, 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6 plus 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. 55. That is the sum of digits. Divided by 55 into 2014 is the first year in the life. Remaining life is 9 plus 1. This is in lakhs. So type 22 lakh divided by 55 into 10. 22 lakh divided by 55 into 10. How much?
4 lakh.
4 lakh. Not over yet. If you only subtract 2014 depreciation, you will get WDV for 1115. I want WDV for 1118. Less depreciation for 2015. 22 lakhs divided by 55 into, please tell me, 2015 is the second year in life. Remaining life is 8 plus 1, 9. How much do you get?
3 lakhs.
3 lakh? 60,000. Less depreciation for 2016. 22 lakh divided by 55 into 7 plus 1, 8. 3 lakh 20,000. Less depreciation for 17. 17 is 1, 2, 3, 4th year in life. 6 plus 1. 22 divided by 55 into 6 plus 1. 2,80,000. Now I will get WDV on 1,118. How much? 1,118. How much is it? Subtract. Out of this, you subtract all these depreciation numbers.
10,40,000.
How much?
10,40,000.
So I now find out the WDV of the machinery at the beginning of the year, 10,40,000. Now I have to calculate depreciation for 2018 also, no? Look at the board. 22 lakh divided by 55 into, now 18 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th year in life. Remaining life is 5 plus 1. 2,40,000. 2018 is 5th year in life. Remaining life is 5 plus 1, 6 years. Getting closed? No, there is a profit. 2 profit and loss account. How much? 2 lakh. Profit. Before we go to the next topic, listen to me very carefully. Comparison between SLM method and WDV method. Between SLM method and WDV method. Look at the board, everyone, please. Suppose there is a machine like first year, second year, third year, fourth year, and fifth year. Depreciation, if you follow WDV method, depreciation will be 10. I'm just taking an example 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, it's going to reduce. Okay. Now, take a situation where the factory is functioning in the same manner over all these 5 years. All the 5 years, the same number of goods have been produced in the factory with the machine. The goods have been sold at the same price. Company has got the same sales. Company is making the same profits. But if you observe, depreciation is not matching. Activities same, depreciation is reducing. You are using the machine equally over all the 5 years. But you are not giving an equal charge to the P&L account. Is it not a mismatch? Activity and depreciation charge is not matching. It is a mismatch. Yes, if you consider this information, you feel WDT method is not a good method. But if I bring it to another factor, repairs, if I consider repairs also, first year, zero, new machine, normally no repairs. See, when you buy the new, when you buy a new vehicle, new bike, first year we only go to the repair guy to fill gas in our tires, that's it, or to change engine oil. We don't allow him to touch our vehicle. Yes, first year no repairs at all, we feel so comfortable using a vehicle. Second year, clutch will not work, brake will not work. You have to take him to the doctor now. Who is the doctor? The repair guy. He'll say wait for 1 hour. He'll remove the clutch plates or he'll just change the wires. He'll change the brake shoes. He'll say okay, take him. He'll pay him some money. So repairs started out of our pocket. Third year, more trouble will start. The gears won't work. The kick rod won't work. Sometimes the brake will not work, tail lamp, headlamp will not work. Now you have to again go to the service guy. He'll charge you more as repairs. Fourth year, not Apollo Hospital. Fourth year, you are going on very urgent work. The vehicle will stop in the middle of the road and will not start. Whatever you do, it's not going to start. You have to push it to the repair guy. Okay? He'll say there is some engine problem. I have to open the engine. He'll say, give me the vehicle for 2 days. I'll do surgery for it. And then I'll give you the vehicle. Now he'll charge 5,000 or 6,000 because he has opened the engine. So repairs have started increasing. When you use it for 5th year, 6th year, 7th year, every day you have to visit the repair guy at least once. Not every day, at least once in a week you have to visit the repair guy, because something or the other, there will be some trouble. So as the machine becomes old, repairs start increasing. Depreciation reducing, repairs increasing. See the combined charge now. Combined charge to P&L account. 10, 10, 10. 10. If you see, the combined debit to the P&L account is now equal. So now tell me, which method is more appropriate for depreciating machine? WDV method. Why? Because depreciation will reduce, but whatever saving is there, it will be nullified because of a corresponding increase in repairs. Okay? But for assets like building or for assets like patents, copyrights, there are normally no repairs. Buildings also repairs are there, but not very frequent. We don't do every year some repairs to the building. Maybe we may do once or twice painting, that's it. Sometimes every year we don't even do painting. Maybe once in 4 years, 5 years get the building painted. Yes or no? Some people have that habit of painting it every Diwali and Dasara. Some people don't have that habit, so they use the building like that for 4 years, 5 years, then get it painted once again. Yes or no? Are you able to understand? So for assets like building, where repairs don't matter, where repairs are not major, in such case, SLM method is more appropriate. Why? Depreciation charge will be equal. Repairs are negligible. Okay? So for assets like machinery, WDV. For assets like building, patents, copyrights, it is better to use SLM. Okay. Now write down the heading. Change in method of depreciation. Important. Change in method of depreciation. Change in method of depreciation. Write down. Right now, a machine was purchased by TBC Limited. A machine was purchased by TBC Limited for 10 lakh rupees on 1st January 2011. On 1st January 2011, okay. The company was depreciating the machine using straight line method. At the rate of 20% on original cost. The company was depreciating the machine under straight line method. 20% on original cost. So what was the company doing? It was depreciating the machine under SLM method. At what percentage? 20% SLM method on original cost. Okay. On 1st January 2014, you have been appointed as the auditor of the company. According to you, WDV method, according to you, WDV method should be used rate of depreciation 15% per annum. How will you account for this change? Right. The company follows calendar year as accounting period. Company follows calendar year as the accounting period. Stop. Now listen to me carefully. First of all, let us see what has happened till now. Then we'll see what the auditor wants, and then we'll see how to account for that change. Is it clear? Before I continue, I'll tell you. Accounting standard 1. According to accounting standard 1, disclosure of accounting policies. There are three fundamental accounting assumptions: consistency, accrual, and going concern. What do you mean by consistency? Method of accounting should not be changed from one year to other year. Accounting principles, policies should not be changed from one year to other year. You can change only when one law requires it. The company law changes and it says follow only SLM, don't follow WDV. We have to change. Our company law has changed. It says don't follow SLM, only follow WDV from now. You have to change. Accounting standard prescribes a change in policy, change in method. You have to do that change in accounting policy or change in method. Or you feel the new method is, we can say, more appropriate for better preparation and presentation of your financial statements. It will help you to show the results in an appropriate manner. In such case also you can definitely change the method. But accounting can requires, whenever you change an accounting policy or an accounting method, you have to show retrospective effect. What do you have to show? What is the retrospective effect? You have to rectify the books of accounts of the previous year also and then move forward with the new method. Or you tell the shareholder, the investor, if the new method was applied since the beginning, what would have been the impact on profits? What is the impact on profits? What is the impact on the value of the assets? You have to inform that to the shareholder. Okay? So, first of all, let us not go into all that jargon. Let us just try to find out how ABC Limited was preparing machinery account from the date of purchase up to 1st January 2014, the appointment of the auditor. You were the auditor. Okay? Write down machinery account under SLM method. Please be quick. Machinery account within brackets SLM method debit credit 1111 to bank. How much we have purchased machinery for?
10 lakhs.
Now up to 1st January 2014, nobody objected. You always charge at the rate of 20% on original cost, SLM method. 31st December 11th, by depreciation, 10 lakh into 20%, 2 lakh. I think I have already taught you, if percentage is given under SLM method, you should multiply the percentage with original cost, not with depreciable value. Okay? Carried down 18 lakh.
8 lakh.
I got only 8 lakh. Brought down 8 lakh. 31st December 12th. By depreciation. Again. Original cost only you have to multiply. 10 lakh into 20%. 2 lakh. Carried down. 6 lakhs. One thirteen. Brought down. 6 lakh. 31st December 13th. By depreciation. 2 lakh. Carried down 4 lakh. One fourteen brought down 4 lakh. Wait. Here the auditor has objected. He is saying, first till now you have been following SLM. Better than that is WDV. You follow WDV now. Okay. My question is, can we start charging depreciation or WDV method from here? Forget about what has happened earlier. Can you say, Tuch, whatever happened, you forget. From now onwards, let us start following what the auditor is saying, 15%. It cannot be done. Standard prescribes, you have to give retrospective effect. You have to bring the account to a position where the account would have been if the new method would have been followed since beginning. You have to bring up the value of the machine to that value at which it would have been if the new method was followed since beginning. If WDV method 15% was followed from beginning, what value machinery would have shown? First change this to that value and then start charging depreciation under the new method. You cannot simply ignore this. Okay. So let us first try to find out if machinery account was prepared under WDV method, what would have been the value on this day? What would have been the depreciation charged in these 3 years? Now, below this you have some space, no?
Yes, sir.
Leave that space, I need at least 6-7 lines place. Then you prepare, working note,
yes.
Machinery account. See, this is our books. These are our books. This is only our working note. Machinery account, WDV method. 1-1-2011, two bank. How much? 10 lakh. Next, 31st December 11, by depreciation, 10 lakh into 15% now, no?
Yes, sir.
WDV method, 1,50,000.
Carry it down, 8,50,000. 1,12 brought down.
8,50,000. 31st December 12, by depreciation, 1,50,000. Sorry, I'm also sleeping. 8,50,000 into 15%. How much is it? 1,27,500. Carry it down. 7,22,500. 1,13 brought down. 7,22,500. 31st December 13 by depreciation. 7,22,500 into 15%. How much is it? 1,08,375. Carry it down. 6,14,125. 1,14 brought down. 6,14,125. Carefully. This is how account actually is there in our books. This is how it should have been. It should have been like this, but it is how it is there in our books. Now, I want to follow the new method. And I said the standard says you have to show retrospective effect. That means you have to rectify the past also. Simple technique I will say. Tear this paper, paste that paper over. Tear this paper, paste this paper, over. Retrospective effect would be given. But you cannot do tearing, pasting business in accounting because every account is related to some other account. Trial balance will not tally, balance sheet will not tally, P&L account will not tally. So you cannot do that, no? So now what we have to do? Let us say you have to compare. Because of following the wrong method, SLM method, let us assume it is a wrong method, suppose sometime. Correct or it's a wrong method because we all know WDV is superior and compared to SLM for machinery. So we have been following the wrong method till now. 2 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh. How much you have charged depreciation? 6 lakh. How much we should have charged under correct method? Add it up on calculator. How much we have charged? 3 lakh. How much we have already charged? 6 lakh. How much we should have charged? 3,85,875 is what you should have charged. But you have charged 6 lakh. So you have charged excess. If you charge excess depreciation, machinery is understated. Profit is also understated. You have not shown the correct value of machinery to your shareholders and you have also shown lesser profits to your shareholders. Why? You have overcharged depreciation. value of asset has been reduced, value of profits also has been reduced. So now, if we would have followed the correct method, the profits would have been more. Asset value would have been more. By how much? Find the difference. So you can observe, this is the value of machinery. It should have been this much. So how much we have understated the machine value? 4,6,14. 2,14,125. We have shown the machinery value less. That much we have charged excess depreciation. Excess depreciation charged. How will we identify the defect? Excess depreciation charge means excess credit given to the machinery account. Now you have to give a debit, and profit should be credited to the profit and loss adjustment account. So below this you will write, below this you will write, depreciation already charged 6 lakhs. Depreciation already charged 6 lakh. Below here you write, depreciation already charged 6 lakh under SLM method. Depreciation which should have been charged under WDV method. How much should have been charged in the WDV method? 3 lakh? 85,000? Write down 3,85,875. Depreciation which should have been charged? 3,84,875. This is the revenue we should have charged. 3,84,875. Okay? You're right. Excess depreciation charged in books of accounts. 2,14,125. Excess depreciation charged in books of accounts 2,14,125. So we have charged excess. We have written off more. Now we have to do write back. Write down entry for rectification. You will write machinery account retard to profit and loss adjustment account. Machinery account retard to profit and loss adjustment account. Machinery account retard to profit and loss adjustment account. How much? 2,14,125. Is the amount which should be debited to machinery account. Now come to your books. These are your books. That is only working note, rough notes. This is your book. Here you write to P&L adjustment account 2,14,125. What is entry you wrote? Machinery account retard to profit and loss adjustment account. No. So this amount will be credited to your profits. So what are you telling your shareholders through this entry? You are telling the shareholders that boss, because of following the old method, we have understated our machinery value by 2,14,000. Whatever we have understated, now we are increasing. And profits were also understated by 2,14,125, which are, we are now crediting it back to the profit and loss adjustment. Okay. Now, members in the general meeting, they will ask questions. Directors, why did you follow this method since beginning? You have reduced the value of machines and you have reduced our profits. You did not declare us dividends. Then you know that there was a more appropriate method. Questions will be raised. That is why it has to be shown. Is it clear? The board should have an answer for this. Why you have been following the wrong method? Now from here you can follow WDV. But you have to add both of them now. Because book value will now change. 31st December 2014 by depreciation. Now you will say 6,14,125 into 15%. In the year it was SLM. From here it will be WDV now. How much?
5,22,000.
5 lakh?
22,000.
We'll have a 5 minutes break and then we'll continue.